Hi everyone, myself Supriya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss the drainage system for the building. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the learner will be able to impart the knowledge of drainage supply system for the buildings. The drainage system, it is an entire system of the pipelines which is led for providing the water supply to the buildings. It is also called as an arrangement of a pipe for a building for the collecting or the conveying the waste water by gravity to the public sewer or a domestic septic tank. So this is the drainage or house drainage plan. The WC is the water closet, whereas a WB is the wash basin. SP is the soil pipe, the wastewater pipe, next you have the vent pipe, the rainwater pipe, the gully trap and the inspection chamber. Overall, this all should be included in the house drainage pipe. This is the main road. Over here we have the service lane and the inspection chamber. You can see that they are provided at all the corners of the buildings and they are provided at a certain interval, you can say. And this is the SP line, it is provided where you have the WCs, that is the soil pipe. It is a pipe which collects the waste coming from the washrooms, which contains the human excreta. Whereas we have the wastewater pipe, the water when used for the different purposes like the commercial buildings, the domestic or the industries which consist of the impurities, they are collected in the wastewater pipe. Whereas you have the vent pipe we have, which is provided in the which is provided here, the vent pipe. It is a pipe which is provided for the circulation of the air to and from the drainage system. The RWP is the rainwater pipe for the collection of the rainwater. So next we will see about the gully trap. Gully trap, it is provided at a junction of a roof drain or any other drain from the kitchen or etc. So we have the sewage. The sewage is nothing but the wastewater coming from the WCs, which contains the human excreta. So where the sewer is nothing but the pipe carrying the sewage is called as the sewer. And on the other hand, the sludge is provided with the wastewater coming from the kitchens, the wash basins, etc. That is called as the sludge. So following are the components of the house drainage system. In that you have, first is the traps, second is the inspection chamber, third is the plumbing system and fourth is the sanitary fitting. So out of this we will be seeing about the traps and the inspection chamber. So traps and its types. The traps are the U-shaped fixtures that have the water seal in it. They also create, the water in the trap creates a water seal which prevents the sewer gas passing from the drain pipes into the occupied space in the building. So actually they are classified based on the shape and based on the use. So according to the shape, they are classified further as the P-trap, the Q-trap and the S-trap. Whereas the classification according to the use, it is done as flow trap, which is also called as the Nahani trap. The second is the gully trap, third is the intercepting trap and fourth is the grease trap. So let us see further. So the P-trap, here you can see that the P-trap, it is mostly installed under the most of the house sinks. It is fitted with a 90 degrees at the outlet. So this is the depth of the water seal. So it is the most common which is used in the house sinks. The Q trap. You can see that the shape of this trap is similar to that of the S trap. It is mostly provided in the upper floors rather than the ground floors. So this is the depth of the water seal, which is around 60 to 70 mm. This is the crown, where you have the deviation in this. So these are the traps which are provided in the toilets under the water closet. The S trap, S trap is a it is a siphonage pipe. This is the depth of the water seal. So it is a the benefit of the S trap is that you can prevent the large materials such as the rings to enter into the drainage system, and it even avoids the sewer gases. The S trap traps the water. The shape traps the water so that the odors from the sewer do not come into the drain. So this is the benefit of the S trap. The Nahani trap, or also called as the floor trap, it is a trap which is used to admit the sludge coming from the floors of the rooms, the kitchens, bathrooms, etc. So they are provide. It is made up of the. It is made up of the stainless steel, and even the galvanized gratings are provided at its top to prevent the large materials to enter into the drainage system, and even the chances of the blockage are reduced. This is the gully trap. You can see that this trap, it is provided at a junction of a roof drain and any other drain from the kitchen or the bathrooms. So the CI grating, the top of this gully trap, it is made up of the CI grating, and they are mostly made up of the stoneware or the CI, that is the cast iron gully trap. So the mostly they are used in the upper floors rather than the ground floors. The depth of the water seal is 60 to 70 mm, and they are mostly installed in the masonry chambers. They are mostly fitted with the inside a masonry chamber. This is a grease trap. So the grease trap, it is mostly used in the large hotels, the restaurants to collect the oily material or the oily substance. So it is mostly used to prevent the oily substance entering into the drainage system, so that the foul gases or the scum cannot be the ugly. It doesn't cause any ugly scum, or the blockage of the drainage has to be reduced. The greasy matter which is floating on the top can be easily removed using this trap. The intercepting trap, it is provided at a junction of a house sewer and a municipal sewer. So the waste material or the waste coming from the municipal sewer, it avoids it to enter into the house drainage or the drainage system. It avoids the foul gases of the municipal drainage to enter into the house drainage system. So you can see that from the house drain to the house drainage system, it avoids the scum, or it avoids the foul gases to enter inside. So a tight fitting plug is provided at its top, and this is the cleaning eye or the rodding arm. Here is the depth of the water seal, which is less than the other traps. The pipes and its types. So there are various pipes available with us, and the size of them is specified here in the table. Here you can see that the soil pipe, it is the size should be around 100 mm, whereas the waste pipe, the size is 30 to 50 mm, and the wastewater pipe, it is 75 mm, whereas the vent pipe, which is used for the circulation of the air, it is around 50 mm, and the rainwater pipe, it should be 75 mm, and the anti-siphonage pipe should be 50 mm. So here you can pause the video for 2 minutes and try to give the answer for this. Hope so you have got the answer. These are the references. Thank you.